Today I'm going to show you how you can use per channel contrast to make your images stand out and add that dramatic pop that your image deserves. Also, we'll learn a few camera raw tricks to add dimension and boost the details. It's super easy to do, so without any further ado, let's get started. So here we are in the magical world of Photoshop again, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo and follow along, check the links in the description. So the first thing that we have to do is create a curves adjustment layer, my favorite, all-time favorite. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then simply choose curves. Now inside of curves, of course, we can add contrast by taking these sliders, taking the right slider to the left and taking the left one to the right. What that does is that it expands the dynamic range, makes the darkest part of the image absolutely black, and makes the brightest part of the image absolutely white. Now that's one way of doing it. It pushes all R, G, and B channels. Keep in mind, an image is made of red, green, and blue. What if we push the channels separately? That's going to give you a more pleasing and interesting contrast, which is dramatic. So all you need to do, you need to select the red channel and then bring the slider to the point where it begins to lose the details. Just when it begins to lose the details, stop. Beyond this point, it will lose the details in the clouds. We don't want that. And there's one great way of checking this. All you need to do is to hold the Alt or Option when you play with the slider. Just when you begin to see the artifacts, it means that you're losing details. Do the same with the left-hand side. It's okay if you're losing the details a little bit there, doesn't matter much. Just see how that looks. I think I'm gonna go with just a little bit over here. Let's go to the next channel, green channel. We have a lot of space to cover right here. So let's bring it to the left and let's bring the left one to the right. Wonderful. If we take a little too much, it's gonna become a little magenta. We don't want that. So up until this point is fine. Let's go to the blue channel and we're gonna do the same. Not so much blue because I like it a little yellowish. I'm gonna keep it at that. And let's take this slider to the right. It adds amazing yellows. I love that. Now let's get back to the RGB channel and let's see if we can take this slider even further. So you can hold the Alt or Option and take it to a point where it begins to lose the details. So at this point, I guess it is losing details. So I'm going to stop right there. And that's how we have increased contrast per channel. Let's have a look at the before and after. So here is the before. Here is the after. Look at that. It looks amazing. Now you can of course play with color tones or something. So if you go to the blue channel, if you liked a little bit more blue here, so you can just increase the blue a little bit. And that's absolutely fine. Just to let you know, there's an automatic way of doing this as well. So let's collapse this. Let's turn it off. Let's create one more curves adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. And the automatic way is pretty simple and straightforward. Click on this grid over here and then click on auto options. And inside of that, you will have enhance per channel contrast and hit OK. It automatically does the exact same thing. If you go to the red channel, it has brought the slider to that point. If you go to the green channel, see the point where it begins to lose the details, it has brought it exactly to that point, even with the blue channel. Now the problem with this is that you don't have manual controls over it. So let's say I wanted a little more yellowish and I wanted to take this a little bit to the right. So it doesn't give you that kind of manual controls, but you can use this as a starting point. So anyway, there are two ways of doing it. Let's reset it. Let's try auto options, enhance per channel contrast, hit OK. So this is one way of doing it, automatic. This is another way, which is manual. Wanted you to know both so that you know the concept. Now on top of this, we can try lots of interesting effects. We can create one more curves adjustment layer, maybe camera raw effects, whatever you like. So let's create a curves adjustment layer. We have to make the car stand out. So click on the adjustment layer icon and choose curves again. And with the help of the hand tool right there, click and drag it up to make this area a little brighter. And if you want to make this area a little darker, click and drag it down. See, adding contrast around the car. So I'm just playing around it. There you go. Just a little bit brightness over here. Have a look, here's the before, here's the after, and I just want it on the car. So select the mask, press Ctrl or Command I, take the brush, make sure it's a soft brush, and then paint around the car. That's it, with white as the foreground color. So you can select the soft round brush from here and just paint. Nothing complex right there. Smoothing, we don't need any of that at this moment. Let's erase it from the clouds. Press X to toggle between the foreground and the background. And we don't need it in the clouds. So just a little bump to the car, as you can see. Now, after that, there's one more thing that you can do. It's camera raw effects. It's amazing. So press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and E to create a merged layer. Now, before you apply camera raw filter, let's convert this into a smart object. So go to Filter, Convert for Smart Filters, hit OK, so that we can change the values of camera raw later. Then go to Filter, and then Camera Raw Filter. There are lots of things you can do here. First of all, let's increase the shadows. We are just focusing on the car at this point. See, we are getting so much details. And then increase the clarity. It adds so much more details to the car. But we don't want so much of it, too much of it, because it creates halos. A little bit is fine. And then maybe we will decrease the highlights a bit to get details in the headlights. And then increase the whites. This looks amazing. Just on the car, right? You can also try increasing the contrast a little bit. That's great. Now, once you're happy with this, just hit OK. And this is just for the car, nothing else, right? So you can hold the Alt or Option, click on the Mask button. It creates a negative mask. Then take the brush, white as the foreground color, just paint on the car for the details. There you go. Now, as you can see, the car is absolutely standing out. You can also paint nearby ground. There you go. It's wonderful, isn't it? Also, what you can do, you can also create one more for the clouds. So you can make a copy of this one. So with layer one selected, which is the one with camera raw, let's make a copy of this, Control or Command J. And this one is for the clouds. Let's name it camera raw clouds. And here we can actually delete the mask all over again. Double click on the camera raw. And this time just let's focus on the clouds. Just simply increase the dehaze a little bit more to get more details in the clouds. Decrease the highlights. Wow. Increase the whites even more. Decrease the highlights. Now, once you're happy with this, hit OK again. Now, hold the Alt or Option. Click on the Mask button. This was just meant to be for the clouds. And with white as the foreground color, just paint on the clouds. That's all you need to do. You can also try on the sky. And there you have it. On top of this, you can also try some color lookup tables as well. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose color lookup. And there are lots of them that you can try. So I'm just going to scroll through them. You know what? The late sunset was absolutely amazing. And we can decrease the opacity of it or change the blend mode as well. But I'm going to try decreasing the opacity a little bit and apply a tad bit. Maybe 32% or let's go 25%. I loved it. Now select the mask again, take it away from the car because we want it to be absolutely red. See how it's standing out? So we're going to go 30%. Now let's have a look at the before and after. Here's the before. Here is the after. Dramatic change, right? Now if you think the overall effect is too much, you can select the layer just on top of the background layer, hold the Shift key and then select the topmost layer. Press Ctrl or Command G to make a group and decrease the overall opacity. And gradually increase it to your liking. 75% is great before, after. So that's how to create dramatic and impactful images using per channel contrast. All you have to do is to create a curves adjustment layer and then go through the different channels, red, green, and blue. And have a look at the histogram and the sliders. Just at the point where it begins to lose the details, stop. Now you don't have to follow the rules, you can go beyond or go less. It is your choice and your artistic expression. Now, after you have increased the contrast per channel, then you can go ahead and add any effect that you want. You can create more curves adjustment layers or maybe camera raw filters as well. So that's pretty much it for this video. I hope this tutorial helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for all your support. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.